Okay, everyone. Gonna do some more EverQuest live streaming. We're going live right now. And I am going to be running a low-level shaman because I'm a little frustrated with the healing and the buffing going on in the game for the TLPs. So I'm gonna try my hand at running the shaman around. Well, we'll see what happens. It is very low level. It's only like level 3, so there's not going to be much grouping, leveling, or buffing and healing. Not yet. So give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. I had to grab my iPad so I could see if anybody was chatting with me. So, what we're going to do is just go out to what they call the racetrack. Oh, excuse me. And the racetrack is a circle in the newbie yard where the mobs basically just go round and round. If you miss them the first time, you can catch them the second time. Alrighty. So we're gonna go ahead and head out. Got ourselves buffed up. More than likely, by the time I get to where I'm going, the bus will have fallen off, but it doesn't matter. Nope. What I get for trying to wander around here without the map up. Although I have had several shamans over the years, shamans, whatever, I rarely spend any time in the origin city. So we're gonna swim over. And head for the newbie yard. Got my mage, which will be my primary character, up to level 35 today. I will continue to level it up as I go. And the area they call the racetrack is basically down in here. Round and round they go. You're wasting your time going down in here. Just stay in this loop. I like to set up right here in this gap right there. You can also come down in here, I believe. And it gets pretty good. The only thing about the newbie yard here is there's a level 8 skeleton that will kill unsuspecting low-level characters. Good weapon for a shaman is any kind of a piercing weapon. This one happens to be a spear, but you can use, I believe I've seen harpoons used, all kinds of stuff. Can't use daggers. I don't believe shaman can handle daggers. Clubs. Spears, nothing slashing, pretty sure. It's a big zone. Halas is a big zone. And let's see here. I am surprised that thing didn't come at me. No pup. Aggravating pup. Usually they attack you when you're engaged with something else. The bear. Last time I was out here, the bears were running at me just as hard as they could go for some reason. That's not good. To head down into here. Let me see. Nope, that's a regular skeleton. Easy kill. Easy money. Punch him. skeleton popped up right in front of me, and I was afraid it was the level 8 one that will kill you quickly. Trying to avoid having to run from him, because you can run, but you won't outrun him. I like this server much better, because in the old days, if that person or two people over there saw me fighting something, could run up and take it from me. There was absolutely nothing I could do about it, because the two of them could outdamage me. To end something. It's because two of those two people can out damage a single person easily. So you really didn't have any recourse. I want to get to level 5 in this area and then go to a more familiar stomping ground from there, which is going to be where the high elves are, which is Felwith. So I would prefer to level up with this character there than to mess around here. This is a good place to set up because they come over the hill there, come right at you. And you just sit and wait for them to pop up. And at higher levels, the shaman have pretty awesome dots. They have an okay nuke with the Got the poison dots that take a put on. Pretty nice. They also have a great slow. If you're in a group and you're on a shaman, they don't want you there too slow. Off heal is not bad. If you're the primary healer, there's going to be trouble. Just going to say. Shaman, unless you're on a live server and can get two items to boost your wisdom, you're not going to be much of an effective healer. For instance, my wisdom is 105, and that's the way the character was created. That was max. Hindsight being 2020, I probably should have adjusted the starting stats for Dex. But I was in a hurry to create the character, and I didn't pay any attention, to be honest. I'm happy. I mean, the Dex would have been a maybe a 5-point improvement. But that's probably all I would have done. So 5 points in the grand scheme of things. That can be easily overcome later. Now that's the kind of polar bear I was thinking I was going to run into here earlier. One that sees me and comes running. And slaps a big old fat paw on your head. Word got out. Go up here and med a little bit. I need to rebuff. Make sure Mr. Billy Bear does not come over here and smack me while I'm sitting. We're at 53%. That's good. Go buffing away. Okay, buffs are on and mana is empty. That's about where it goes with the shaman, barbarian shaman. That's the life we live. Sit here a minute and mana back up, and then we'll start pulling. Okay. Thank you. Stupid bear is gonna get me killed. Wow, that bear walked right past me and didn't jump me. Can't say I'm going to return the favor. Bit. Oh, no we won't. We're gonna start beating down on a gnoll pup. I didn't see him. Oh, he saw me. He's a little butthead, short and stout. Okay, let's go here. Usually when I'm parked up here on the side of this hill, they don't mess with me, but I must have a bigger aggro range than what I remember. Try this again. We're gonna park Fanny on ice and see what happens. Okay. see where we're at here. Alteration. Okay. For Shaman, you need your alteration maxed out at all times. If you don't, you'll wish you had. That's the majority of your spells that you're going to cast are going to be alteration. I've maxed Evo because that's the nuke is what I'm using currently. But later there'll be dots, and the dots will require alteration. So if you're going to want that alteration spell maxed out. Your heals require it. Your dots require it. Your buffs require it. I think your buffs require it. Let me look real quick. It may be abjuration, but I thought it was alteration. It is. It's alteration. Yeah, every one of these is, well, except that one. That's abjuration. But the really cool and groovy stuff is going to be alteration. So try to keep it maxed out. You can tell I've got lousy wisdom. It's not bumping up very much, if at all. Keep casting, keep trying to get that bumped up. So abjuration is called inner fire. I may be wrong about what is this thing called? Yeah, inner fire. It's been a while since I played a shaman. Been a while since I played any character in Everquest. Okay, I will go ahead and rebuff across the board, and then we'll move on, keep killing until we get to level 4. And we'll rinse and repeat and go to level 5. And then I'll start hoofing it across the zone to get out of here. Strength on. I forgot I didn't have that working. I've got to find some fish scales somewhere. That should do it. Good, good, good. Mana back up and we're ready to go. As you can see, the shaman is a little difficult to keep full mana, even if you're just casting low-level buffs. So, I got a feeling a lot of mana bottles, potions, mana potions will be bought on the low end to help get the character up and running. Okay. There we go. Alright. Need you guys to come on around the corner here. That will do. Walk past me. I saw you disappear. And then you want to break out the claws. Tell you what. Okay. Thank you. See, I had a feeling you guys were gonna try to gang up on me. Bastards. You cabbages. Yep, there's another one. Nice to get my first dot. Make sure I leave out of here with the No, you're okay. Have to be careful. Not all skellies are made alike. Really want to tame with that level 8 skeleton. But I mean, it's a named boss, so it's not like you can. If you click on him, you'll notice the difference right away. Number 1, he's red all day long, and number 2, he's got a name. I'm so sorry, excuse me. I couldn't mute the mic before that happened. Oh, mercy. Allergy and hay fever season or whatever they... Mercy. Let me go ahead and sit down and med up a little bit. Ah, mercy, mercy, mercy. Ah. And, okay, 83%, that's not bad. On guard. Oh, God, don't. Yeah, no, this is dating myself, but that little mouse that went after Tom, that was, they thought he was one of the Three Musketeers, was the funniest thing. Yes, I called you a bony butt. Get over here.
Mm-hmm.
100%. Great. On the bandwagon. Gonna crash the party, I know he is. I can tell by looking at him. Cutting his eyes up. What is this? Medium quality. Spiders don't run. I want you, Mr. Spider. Oh, two of them. Okay. Gotta make sure you eyeball every skeleton that comes near you. You never know when it's gonna be that named. Mana, and I need to sit. Sometimes I comes to sit, and sometimes I comes to sit and think. Gotta be close. Yep, we are close. I just didn't have any mana. Where are we at? 92%. And boom, just like that, we're at 100. Okay. I want the skelly with the stick. The reason you want the skelly with the stick is it has a good chance of being a cracked staff, and a cracked staff is worth a plat. And if you're in the early stages of a brand new server, definitely want that flat. And a long way towards getting you worn great staff. We do not want that. That's not worth anything. Okay, so we're going to sit, med, and mem new spells. So that's hello, what are you? You are False Rift and you are Fleeting Fury. It's a haste. Gate Drowsy, which is a slow. Endure Fire buff. Okay. Okay, so that's what you're looking for is we're gonna move some stuff around. So we're gonna put trying to think, is this my first dot or is it another nuke? A nuke evocation. Okay. So feet like cat goes here. And strengthen goes next to the heel. Okay. So that's level 4. We'll go ahead and cast up the buffs. Full mana bar. That's a happy place to be.
Woo.
Don't want to use that spell too often. I burned up 25%, 20% of my mana. That some of these spells got. Have a seat, mana up as much as we can. I'm creating gaps in the environment so to give me time to get mana back up. Somebody went by with two null pups. Oh, there's one. Okay, Vengeful Composer, that is the click him. That is a level 8 skelly with a hammer on him. But you don't want to mess with him unless you're in a group or you're a higher level than me, which is 4. I don't want none of that. So either he will move on or he'll come back from the way he came. Go back the way he came. Either way, I'm going to leave him alone until he goes away. There he goes. Let's see if I can move his buddy by himself. Looks like it. Looks like I was a success on that pull. Spider jump on me. That's odd. Yeah, I heard him by accident. Trying to get the bear. Just to make sure I'm not getting hit by the level 8 skelly who happened to roam back the way he came. Good, health is good. Oh, I can kill 1,000 more than this thing. I hope they're not fine. Oh, man. Anything to do with him. We're going to run up here on the side of this hill and sit down. Get out of his way. Stay out of his way. And hopefully he doesn't aggro on me and come running up this hill. Remember, line of sight. Gotta break line of sight. finish this one off. Take a quick break. I need to ask a question of someone. Alright, I am going to mute the mic and I will be back in about a minute. Okay, I am back. Sorry about that. Had to go take care of something real quick. Okay. Say this, it's nice to be able to attack spiders and not get poisoned back. There we go. Because usually messing with spiders is going to get you spider bitten poisoned. Polar bear decided to join the party. There's another one coming up behind me. If he goes socialize with the one he's smacking. And, I here, bring the wolf with me. Boom. Need to do something on screen, so give me a minute. I'm sorry. I keep starting and stopping this session. Take me a couple more minutes. Oh, that's right. Okay, didn't need to do that. Reset this. Okay, and back to the stream. There we go. The buffs are getting low enough, I'll just rebuff before I run out there. Since we're on full mana, we'll jump out there and start killing mobs again. Wow, that was a lot of mobs running after that one person. I hope they were taking those things back to a camp somewhere. Okay. Interesting. DS on this character as much as he gets hit. popped him with the shield and broke him. Spell. Didn't mean to do that. Okay, let's go up here and sit down. Okay. Percent. Backpack. I can use that all day long. I can use one more. Wow. Resistant. Polar bear, you're getting on my nerves. Two around. You're definitely working my nerves. Add a little bit. Excuse me. Sorry. It's been a rough weekend. Hey, Matt. Leveling this shaman. How was your weekend? Yeah, the new TLP Oakwynd came up like a Wednesday ago. Too short, yeah, no joke. I hear you. I could use one more day. It was great. We kind of split it up. I took Friday off and pretty much stayed on the TLP all weekend. And then my wife wanted to make a gambling run, so we ended up going to casino, a local casino that opened up about 2 hours away. And had a good time there. And met up with a friend of ours and had a real good time gambling. Didn't bring any money home, unfortunately. How many times do you do that? And then Sunday, pretty much stayed inside. It rained pretty much all day Sunday where I am. So stayed inside. Did a little EverQuest, a little Star Trek Fleet Command. I'm probably going to be moving up soon. I've got 5 shards left to pull, or excuse me, BPs left to pull from a Gladius. And when I pull those tomorrow, I'm going to give everyone a 24-hour head start notice, basically a notice that I am Wednesday morning. I'm going to start my run for 32 and try to get the shipyard built up so that I can make said Gladius. So I probably had 6 people in the stream this morning. I think they were checking on me because I've been teasing this for about a week or so. Thank you. 5 BPs left, and I've got what I need to pull them. I just need to pull them and start my run. I don't think I am familiar with that. How do you like it? Is it a shoot 'em up, or is it some kind of MMO, or what is it? I think I've heard of the title, but I don't know anything about it. The RPG. Ah, okay, cool. Yeah, that's oh crap. That's not good. And all my buffs are down. Well, yep, there he comes. I am in serious doo doo. Yep. He is going to keep punching me in the head until I fall over, and he's going to kill me. Wonder how the pathing is in this part of the world. Sometimes you can beat him if you can figure out where the pathing is bad in the game, and you go straight across somewhere where he takes the long way around. But that doesn't often happen. We'll see. Nah, he ain't playing it. He is not playing. He caught me. He caught me with my buffs down. Let's see here. It's done by the people who made Witcher game. Oh, now I like Witcher. So they've cleaned it up, straightened it up, all that stuff. Oh yeah, it's just a matter of time now. He's got me. Two are happy, you and your skelly buddy, Mr. Bear, little shithead. Yeah, he's level 8. He terrorizes all the low levels here in this zone. Normally, I have spotted him two or three times in the last hour and a half or so. And but I happened to be facing the right direction. And this particular time, I had my back to him, and he caught me. Cool. I'll have to take a look at that. Did you pick it up in the store, or did you get it off of Steam? Yeah. Yeah, that's where I get most of my new stuff. Let's see here, 40%. Yeah. Yeah, those days have pretty much ended. I tell you, sometimes I wish I still had my wife. A few years ago, it's probably been 10, I had the disc that belonged to every game I ever played since EverQuest came out. In fact, I still had the original EverQuest disc. My wife made me go through that mess and throw them away. You don't play this anymore. Why don't you just throw the disc away? Famous last words. Okay, sorry about that. I've clicked the mic off. My wife came in and was asking me something. So, let's see, when I moved to Florida, I made the mistake of putting my game box on the moving truck. Oh, man. Yeah, a good friend of mine moved up to where I am from out of state, and they put all kinds of things that you just don't put on a moving truck. They put kids' piggy banks, these 5-gallon pickle jars full of money. They gave them to the movers. Surprise, surprise, they disappeared. They put electronics on the moving truck, TVs, stereos, computers, monitors, you name it. It went in a box and went in. And the thing was, they labeled it. Yeah, exactly. All that stuff fell off the back of that truck. So fortunately, they kept a good record of what went in the boxes. I think this guy's wife was a little bit OCD, because not only did she have the outside of the box labeled, she knew what was in the box. So when they didn't show up, she could hand them a list and go, this was what was in there. The biggest problem was, so they got a check from the company, but the biggest problem was they didn't know how much money was in those 5-gallon pickle jars. So they got hosed because they didn't know how much money was in them. So I think the trucking company said, okay, well, We're going to assume there's at least $100 in there, so we're going to add $100 for each of the two jars because I had two kids. And my buddy was like, it's not $200. It was probably $1,000 in each one of those things because the grandparents were funneling money into the pickle jars, too. Yeah, it never is. Yep. I'm going to experience that for the first time in my life. I think when my wife and I retire, because we've always self-moved. Every move I've ever made in my life, I've got a U-Haul and I moved myself. I've never had somebody else move me. Not unless it was family. So, a new experience for my wife and I coming up. Having somebody else move you. You just box it up and they haul it off. That'll be fun. Yeah. You never had it. It was never there. Wow, 14 boxes. Damn, that's a lot, man. Yeah, my buddy's experience helped me. My daughter, her husband, don't be play. Oh, whoa! Hello. My goodness. Where did you guys come from? When she moved, her husband was in the Coast Guard. When she moved two or three times, and I told her about the experience that my buddy had, and she was all over it. She made sure she inventoried each box, what was in the box, what the value was. I mean, she was ready. Anybody tried to mess with her, she was gonna stick them with a bill. Yeah, it's like, y'all go away. Where did y'all come from? Yeah, I'll probably be streaming this. I'm gonna try to hit level 5 with this character. I mean, I just created it when the server came up, but I have not played it yet. So I'm gonna try to hit level 5 with this character before I stop streaming tonight. But I've got my stream for this new MMORPG. Well, it's not new. It came out in 1999. It's 24 years old. But the new server, they've released a new server, so I'm gonna, and I like it. There's a new rule set for the server. You can see that the labels to the mobs that I'm fighting, they're red. Those things are locked to me. No one else can run up and grab them from me. I have to either kill it, die, or intentionally release the lock before somebody else can get them. That was a big thing with this particular game. You could be engaged with something to get a particular drop or whatever, and somebody could run up out DPS you, and they would get the kill. They would get the, what's going on with you? Huh. And they would get what you were after. And it's like, so they came up with a mechanism to lock them. And I'm really, really liking it. You know, all the people who engaged in activity, who would come up and kill you for your, your drop, they were screaming and hollering. Boy, they did not like it. I'm never playing this game again. Good, go away somewhere else. Only if they're in a group with me, or if I invite them into a group with me. But I have to do that before I engage the mob. Now, they can't help me kill it, but they can help me survive it. So if they can heal me, if they cast a heal on me, it'll land on me. But if they try to attack the mob, it will not. They can't do any damage to the mob. Oh, these are all low level. I'm like level 4 here. So all of these characters are 2s and 3s and 4, except for that damn skeleton that killed me. It was level 8. Yes, I went too far. I should be back over here. Yep. There we go. Yeah, so as soon as I cast on it, it turns red on the name. And then the only thing someone else can do is keep me up. They can't steal the kill and take the goodies. Company says if if the reviews are positive, they're gonna roll it out to the other servers that they have. And of course, the raiders didn't like it. But they had a legitimate concern. I mean, how do you control it when you're in a raid? Oh yeah, definitely. I've got 400,000 across the board for ore, and all that happy stuff. But I need to do some more. And when I left the game running. Yep, I need to move my ship. I was mining the decoded data, the green dot stuff, not the red dot stuff. But I really haven't played much today. I played some this morning. Well, I did my stream this morning like normal. And helped the new member, Pilgrim, something like that. Anyway, Pilgrim. So, helped him with a formation armada he needed the points for. That is pretty much all I've done today. the that last battle pass. I know they have different people doing this stuff, but when there's a lot of crap, you have to spend hours mining and all that stuff. It gets on my nerves. I hate mining. Yeah, I did. I've got my miner on the green data stuff. I did some lat with my DeVore. Might have been Sunday. I can't remember, but I realized that I was low and I was like, oh crap. So I did about half a million, maybe 700,000 in lat. And then I was building up the ore and stuff for a bonus refinery, because I know that I keep looking for it to be announced, because I know it's coming out. Did she lock that? No, that's good. Okay. But I haven't seen it announced yet. But yeah, this I don't know what it is, but this past battle pass arc really just wore me out. I'm just like almost burnt out on all the must do's things, and it's like, you know, getting on my nerves. And I've got like I said, I've got that Gladius. I've got the last BPs I need to pull. But to build it, you got to be 32. So I'm gonna try to rush through it, to be honest with you. I'm just gonna run the speed ups. I'm just gonna burn every speed up I got to see if I can get there. Yeah, I get the $20 battle pass every month. I was talking with someone this morning, and I had like six people on my stream this morning, so I was kind of surprised because they were talking to me as soon as I logged in. I like the events. I don't like how long it takes for some of these things to be completed, like mining. You got to mine a million of something. Do you know how long it takes to mine a million of something? It's crazy. And there was something. There was something. Some ship kill event that I was working on, and it's like, who in the hell has all this time to kill, like, I don't know, 1,000 ships or something? It's just like, I know what's wearing me out. They got this incursion crap coming in that I hate. So I will not be PvPing anybody. I'm going to turtle up in a low-level system and wait until it's over. I have no patience before PvP being forced on me when I don't want to do PvP. Yeah, what is Jade was mentioning it to me earlier when I had logged in before I started streaming EverQuest, and she told me it was coming, but she didn't say when. Do you know, is it like the first, or is it the weekend? Is that when it's coming? Yeah, I've got 24-hour shields running right now just to make sure I get in the habit of setting them. Where are we at here? We're halfway. Yeah, when does the incursion start? Starts on the 2nd, right? That's why I'm asking you. I'm hoping you know. It is a non-event for me. I'm not doing it. And they can't make me. Okay. Starts on Friday, ends on Sunday. That sounds good. Short-lived, short run, short-lived. I don't know why they insist on doing this stuff. Why do you insist on forcing people to do something they don't want to do in their game? Don't get it. Do not get it. How did I cycle off that? I don't understand. So. Start losing my buffs here. I got to sit down somewhere. So, yeah, I'm going to try to get this character to level 5, and then I'm going to jump back on Star Trek Fleet Command. Yeah, there's already a bunch of 40s out there. It didn't, I want to say it didn't take but maybe like 3 or 4 days, maybe 5, when they unlocked 49 and there were people already there. Just boom. It's like they had their wallets ready. It's like, take my money. Give me my level. Oh. Mm-mm-mm. I guess I don't know. I guess if I had that kind of money, I wouldn't care either, but it makes me cringe knowing how much that probably cost them to do it that way. Yeah, a couple of grand and bam, I'm a 49. That's funny. Oh, I have no idea, but I know it's damn expensive. I do know that. Know that for a fact. There's another content creator that I listen to, and one of his people is a lawyer, a well-to-do lawyer, and she was saying that to go from 50 to 60, and I want to get this right. I think it was all of 50 to get to 60. Or maybe it was only the one level from 59 to 60. Maybe that's what. But anyway, it was 15 grand. That was how much it took to get to 60. I may have it wrong. It may not have been all of the 50s. It may have been just 59 to 60. That's incredible. I had no idea. I mean, I had heard people say, yeah, so-and-so spends 30 grand a month on this game. Not per year, per month. Per month. It's like, are you kidding me? Who the hell has that kind of money to blow away on a game like this? Yeah, I don't buy that many packs. Now I'm not saying I don't buy packs. I certainly do, but I don't buy that many. This game I'm playing right now is much, much cheaper than playing Star Trek Fleet Command, let me tell you. I spend $12.95 a month, and I spend maybe another $20, $25, something like that per month buying stuff. They have their store. I mean, they have their own store. You can buy stuff in here. The best bang for your buck is buying experience potions right here. That's $2.40. And then this bottle here gives you mana recharge for your cat if you're a caster. If you're not a caster, you don't even have to have this. And that's 80 a shot. Each one of those things will last for 4 hours. So in a given day, I'll buy one that'll last for 2 days, and I may not need one every day. I may skip a few days because I'm in a good group or whatever. And I don't need the extra XP. I have a player that's casting the mana potion part of it, so I don't need to use the bottles. And as you can see, I have my own self buffs over here. I'm not running any potions right now. It's a cheap family entertainment. Now there are people on here. Let's see, do I have anybody doing that right now? So the game has renewal tokens. You can buy the monthly pass for like $15, less than that, depends on what you're getting and what you want. But you can also use a token, and it is right here. I don't have any currently, but they're called Chrono, and they go in this slot right here. And Chrono is something you can buy and trade. They let you, you can trade them to other players. You can sell them to other players. You can buy them from other players. And there's a demand for those things. And what they allow you to do is game money called plat. They let you switch out your plat for the Chrono, and there's a market for that kind of stuff. And that's the thing that can make your, if you want the high end drops, you're gonna be paying Chrono for it. And if you buy the Chrono from the vendor of the game, it'll cost you about $18. If you buy it online for somebody who hoards the stuff and drops it on your character while you're in the game, you're about $10 a pop. So either way, I mean, people are advertising choice drops for 10 Chrono. Well, simple math says that's a $100 drop, or it's a $180 drop, or, you know, depending on how you got your Chrono. Yeah, the people who are trying to get you to buy their stuff for Chrono don't like it when you point out the fact that, hey, you just asked for $120 for pixels, buddy. That drop is all it is pixels. You want $120 for that? Really? All right, man. See you when I see you. See you tomorrow, I guess. You have a good night. Thank you. I appreciate it. Almost there, 66%. Not much longer. Got to grind it out. I got to go take a look at my ship, too. I'm mining. It won't go OPC while I'm... No, it's not ready yet. The third time I drop it on that node, it will go OPC. But... Alrighty, so take a little pills, some meds. Good to go. It's all good. Good to go. Close to level 5, which is what I'm trying to get to before I head over to Felwith and adventure there. Can't tell whether those two skellies coming at me are the... Yes, one of them was. The lead one was the bad one. One I do not want to tangle with. Hopefully they're not social. Go. 51%. Nice. Bonjour. Bueno tardes. Bueno noches. Come on, recharge mana. Gotta make a final push. Last 20% till level 5. And gate. There we go. I tell you what, those brittle bones cannot stand up to a shield bash. Missed the bash. I didn't hear the ka-thunk. Come on, where are you guys? Okay, good. Too many get by me. Look at something else. Nails. Be able to see when the skellies are coming. And I gotta cast buffs again. Well, let them build up, or let the mana pool build up, and I can do it. Thought I'd be close to dying by now. Alright. Okay. All right, let's buff it up. Yeah, 91, almost 92. Let's go get busy. Six and a half. Thank you. shit. You can't be kidding me. Alright. Alrighty, I've thrown up the sign for ending soon. Go ahead and end the stream for EverQuest for tonight. Hope you guys have a good evening, and hope you'll catch me again in the future. Appreciate you joining the chat and supporting my effort. Thank you very much.